Hey everybody, welcome back to Marvel Monday. Get your Disney Plus ready. Timestamp to zero and press play now. Feel free to skip the credits if you so desire. Now, this is my all-time favorite episode in the entire series. This one episode captured everything about Thor that I think the MCU attempted to get right, but they kind of missed the mark, in my opinion. I think they kind of turned Thor into a little bit of a puss. See, I liked when he was arrogant and a badass in the beginning of the Thor film, the first Thor film. After that, it just felt like it was a different character. Because in my opinion, I think the arrogant Thor in the beginning of the first Thor film wouldn't have lost the Thanos with Thor, with Mjolnir and Stormbreaker. And so it was part of his development. Yeah, maybe. Still shouldn't have lost the Thanos with Stormbreaker and Mjolnir. And the way they treat Jane Foster in this is exactly how they should have written her in the films. Maybe he likes her, maybe he doesn't, but they can't actually be together because he's a freaking nice guardian. Move back, mortals. Thor the Thunderer, do you please bid it? I mean, even the way it talks is grabbed right out of the comics. Like, Thor is basically Superman and Marvel. Season 2, unfortunately, they just completely dumbed him down. It was him and Captain Marvel. I call it the Superman treatment. Because every time Superman's in animation, all of a sudden he's a weakling. The Wrecking Crew, they don't have any powers. I don't know how they even pull the candle. No, it's a cartoon, but like, seriously. Thor, we got a quick message from thy father. Calls you home. He'll do well. I mean, they attempted to give Chris Hemsworth Thor the helmet. Didn't really work, so I'm kind of glad they got rid of it. So we just straight up leaves her to go back to Asgard. And I'm like, oh my God, Jane, I can't live without you, Jane. That old Peter Parker thing in Spider-Man 2. I want to get laid, so I'm not going to lose my powers now. Oh, I can't wait to talk about that one. That's going to be hilarious. When you want to talk about like perfect direct adaptations of characters, Tom Hiddleston's Loki is stepping right out of the comics. That's why it became so popular. The guys are so good in the role. It's unfortunate that the Loki series is kind of a waste now. Well, that's it for Kang, and then they're not going to use the character. It's a waste. And can we talk about how they did Lady Sif so dirty in the MCU? Cavity. Like, Sif is supposed to be thrown away from the comics. They just completely wrote her out for in favor of Jane Foster, who should have been killed off or written out after the first film. And she got that ether stuff in her, should have killed. Well, I understand they brought her back as a chick Thor or something. I haven't bothered to watch that one. I have no interest in it. Welcome home. I always loved how cunning and mischievous Loki is. He's his Lex Luthor type character. I never read like this motion comic where Loki was basically torturing Thor, then eventually Thor took him out. I kind of applauded it too. I'm like, about time. Only someone should be able to take Thor. Like, you know what? I'm just going to take you down now. Come, brother, you have much to answer. Because, like, Thor and Odin know what Loki is. They just tolerate him until a certain point. I'm sure it'd probably be expensive, but like, kind of wait for a Thor movie where he's going to different realms and fighting different monsters instead of all this Earth crap. He would have got more of the Enchantress. I'm a little disappointed I didn't get to see in Thor from the MCU. She's a really cool character. And the arc she goes through in this is kind of interesting. It's just another missed opportunity with the show being canceled so soon. We'll get to see it resolved now. Yeah, because in what is it called? Ragnarok? They call it Thor a comedy. I mean, sort of into a joke. And from what I understand, the one after that is even worse. Yeah. And I often wonder where we would be, what season this show would be on right now if it hadn't been canceled so prematurely. Guess we'll never know.